With Silhouette 2022, we now have a choice of over 450 different effect notes, including the full Sapphire Suite and some choice effects from Continuum. In this tutorial, we are going to be taking a look at just a few of them and how we can start to put them together. We're going to be looking at this shot, so I'm going to be relighting the scene, but using the lighting cues that we already have in here. Now, the native silhouette effects have always been divided into different categories. With the introduction of Sapphire as part of Silhouette, you'll see that Sapphire itself has a tab, and then we have further categories that are breaking this down over on the left-hand side here. And there are a huge number of effects that we're definitely not going to get to. But one of my favorite categories is the lighting category. I'm just going to take an S raise and try to enhance the light that's coming in through this blind. So I hit minus on the keyboard to move this around. There we go. And sort of bring this out kind of where the sun would be. And down in the parameters, I'll make my rays a lot brighter. And let's take the threshold down as well so we can get more rays coming in. Just blur those up just a little bit. Okay, but we can already see that we have a bit of an issue coming through. And that's because we're picking up too many of the bright objects in the scene. But that's not a problem. We can just add another effect upstream. And I'm going to just go into the Sapphire Adjust and use just a utility filter, which is S Gamma. And I can just actually use the offset darks just to bring that down a lot and bring the gamma all the way down. Just basically, we're going to be getting rid of everything here, just making it all pretty black. But the reason I'm doing it this way is to show you something that is built into pretty much every Sapphire effect, and that is Mocha. So if I click on Edit Mocha, this brings up a version of Mocha that is built directly in to the effect. So we don't have to add in other Mocha nodes. We can just use the Mocha that's built directly into Sapphire. So I can just create a little area around the window, save and exit, and that blacks out just the window. It's the opposite of what I want, but that's okay because I can just go into my Mocha here and go invert Mocha. Boom. Maybe blur that out just a little bit. But now if we take a look what happens in the edge rays, I'm only getting that going across there. Pretty nice. Now, even the edge rays has an edit Mocha here. Now, this is actually slightly different. Certain Sapphire effects have built-in parameter tracking as well. I've got my center all the way over here, so I have to zoom out and move around. But I could use this to track the blind here. Let's actually just do that while I'm talking. So I'll be tracking the blind here and check out what happens to the center. So the center is moving in concert with this tracking data here. So we've just created a quick track there. So if I save and exit out of here, instead of using this as an additional mask, I can come in over into the node parameters again. Center uses Mocha, and we'll play that back. Look at that. Very nice. So now we've got actually the rays moving up and down in the right sort of way. That's good. So let's just move those over there for a second. I'm going to Alt-click just to add a couple of dots in, just so that our node tree is going to stay looking nice. Let's bring that down there. And I'm going to add in another effect, because I want to have some dust going through those light rays. Now, another new effect for Silhouette is Particle Illusion. Now, Particle Illusion isn't part of Sapphire. It's part of the Boris FX Continuum Suite. So we'll find it over here in Special Effects. So Particle Illusion, I'll just drag that in there and let's just add that over here. Very nice. I'll just launch Particle Illusion. Now, as the name would suggest, Particle Illusion is a particle generator system. And this is just the default viewer here. So over on the left-hand side, we have our presets plus a little preset viewer, just so we can have a little look at what's going on here. There are, you know, thousands of different presets, and we can even search these. So I'm just going to search for some dust because that's what I'm looking for here. And we've got some nice dusty things, including one of my favorite seeds in clouds. I do like that one. Right, I'm going to use floating dust 4K. So this is just a very, very simple bit of dust going on here. I'm just going to double click on this. Let's play this through. You see the dust is just popping in there. I won't do too much with it. I think we'll just leave the dust as it is, and I'll just hit apply. And we've got it back in silhouette. And if I play that back, you can see that the dust is floating around, but it's not matching the movement of the camera. And that's actually easy to fix. So if I come down into my node down here, we've got different ways of doing transforms. So we can either transform the world, if it's just the camera that's moving. We can transform the emitter, if the particle emitter is moving. So we want to track it to someone's hand or a tailpipe or something like that. Or if the world and the emitter are moving, then we can choose world and emitter. So it's only the camera that's moving in this shot. So I'm going to come to transform and go world. And now I have a choice. I can either just keyframe this up, or I can use the data port to bring in tracking data into this, which is exactly what we're going to do. So if I come over to my nodes, I'm going to go to search and go for tracker. And let's bring a tracker over here. And I'll just connect this over there, make this look nice. Just again, holding down the Alt or Option key, just to add in a little dot node there. And let's just track this through. Now, I'm not going to do anything amazingly clever with this. All I want to do is track the back of the wall. I could actually take in quite a big shape. That's not a problem. Come up to my tracker. I'll use the Mocha tracker, and I only want to track in translation. I'll track that forwards, and then when that's done, I'll come to the timeline, see where I need to track it backwards from, and let's just track that backwards. You notice that because I had no layers created, Silhouette automatically made a layer one for me and attached the tracking data to that layer, because tracking data is always attached to a layer. All right, let's rename this one camera track or cam track, and I'll just bring this up and pipe it in to my data port. Get this looking even nicer. There we go. Okay, so if I come back into Particle Illusion now, move to a different frame and come down to my world transform, under the drop down menu, I can see any of the layers that I have connected to the data port. And you'll see that this data port is now available in many effects, specifically for dealing with this parameter tracking. So if I come in and go to camera track, that's going to now give me my world transform that I was after. And that's now moving along with the world. Possibly, like looking back at this, possibly rotation would have been an idea as well, but I think that's going to be fine. The next thing I want to do is actually composite this together so that the dust is only coming through where the rays are. So we need to look at what else Particle Illusion can do when we come up to the top and look at our composite. Because by default, the composite style is set to direct or classic mode, where the particles are composited directly onto the background clip. If we choose alpha plus apply mode, we use the alpha channel from the particles plus an apply mode that we choose here. So this could be overlay, this could be soft light, this could be screen, add, you know, there's lots of different ones that we have available to us. We also have none. And none just shows us the particles. Now, the particles themselves look a little bit bizarre at the moment, and that's only because of another feature we have in our viewer. If we look up at the top right-hand corner, we're looking at this as RGB straight. If we wanted to see this as it would be sort of pre-multiplied on black, this is what we've got. So we hit it over black. Let's just head back to RGB straight.
And I'm going to add another node now, because when I'm composting this, I don't need to work with RGB straight. We're going to see the particles pre-multiplied with black. And surprisingly enough, that node is called pre-multiply. So I'm going to take my pre-multiply, put it on the particle illusion, and now we just have our dots. Great. Let's composite this together. So composite. Okay, so I want my rays to go in the background. I want my particles to go into the foreground. There we go. And I want to use a mat to only see the particles in the area with the rays. So I'm going to take another copy of the rays and just pipe that into the mat input. Now in my composite, I can have a little look, change the drop-down menu from alpha to luminance. And if we play that back, I can now see the rays and the particles only showing in my light beams. And let's use a math composite to composite that over the top. And maybe change that blend mode from add to screen. So I want to boost the rays, but not too much. And through the miracle of editing, let's just tidy this up a little bit more. I'm just going to finish this off with one of our color looks. And because we've got Sapphire built directly into Silhouette now, I could use something like Color Fuse and come in, just bring that in there, and use Color Fuse to find a look that I'm happy with. So I load up the presets, and we've got a lot to look through, including black and white film stocks, color film stocks, or more stylized looks. And as we go through these, you may not see them update in the viewer, which is why we've got these nice, bring this up here, which is why we've got these nice thumbnails to look through to give you an idea of what things are going to look like. So I'm going to take something, where do we go? Let's go M independent hit. There we go. And when we've got it back in the Silhouette interface, we can just use the sliders just to slide that into place there. It's kind of nice. If I didn't want to use Color Fuse, of course, we also have film stocks as a native Silhouette effect. And if we take a look at the presets, there's so many presets in here. They're divided into different categories. So I can look at black and white film or cross-processing, motion picture films. Maybe I'll pop to movie looks. And I kind of like this Hunger Games-y type thing. So let's come back into our node. The best thing about these film stocks is that they're mixed a bit heavily, but we have an amount slider at the very top. So I can always come in and just tweak that to how I want it to be. I can also still have full control over all of these settings. So if I think the blues have become a little bit desaturated, I can just push the blue saturation up a little bit more. Yeah, kind of like that. As we play that back, we can see that I've done exactly what I intended to do when we started out, which is to relight the scene, make it a little bit moodier. And we've done that using a combination of some of the new nodes available to us in Silhouette 2022, including Sapphire effects like Rays and Color Fuse, as well as Particle Illusion to help to bring in some environmental effects. I hope you found this useful. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I hope you join me in more Silhouette tutorials in the future. Bye for now. If you want to learn more about Silhouette or even give it a try yourself, then head on over to boriseffects.com, where you'll find hours of free training for Silhouette, Sapphire, Mocha, Continuum, and all of the Boris Effects products. And you'll also be able to download a free trial.